Welcome to MS Tech. Today we are going to do a budget-friendly review, comparison of five phones which are budget-friendly, which one can buy in between the range of 10,000 to 15,000 Indian rupees. And before we go ahead and start this particular blog, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Your subscription helps us to grow, and we will put some more videos and some giveaways also in the near future. So let's start this particular blog. The top 5 phones of 2017. We will start with Honor 6X. This is priced at ₹10,999 on Amazon. Then we will move to Lenovo K8 Note. This is also one of the best selling phone of 2017. It's priced at ₹12,999. Then we will move to Moto G5S, which is priced around ₹13,999. And then we'll move to Nokia and LG Q6. So Nokia 6 is around 15,000 rupees, and LG Q6 is around 12,999 rupees. So what I've done is that to make it things very simpler, I have made some categories over here. So we'll start with the display comparison. So Honor 6X is having around 5.5 inch LCD LTPS capacitive touchscreen with 1920x1080 pixel resolution. This is full HD. It's having 403 pixel per inch and a color density and 16 million colors support. Okay. While moving on to Lenovo K8 Note, it's having a 5.5 inch full HD screen with 1920x1080 IPS touchscreen with Gorilla Glass 3 protection. Coming back to Moto G5S, it's priced at little higher side at ₹13,999. It's having a 5.2 inch screen, which is at the lower side. So if you're having a small hand or you don't want to have a big screen and you want to have a one single hand operation to be done, touch screen operation to be done, then this is the phone you should be going ahead with. It's a full HD phone with Gorilla Glass protection. Moving on to the next phone, it's Nokia 6. It's priced around ₹15,000. Again, this is a full HD display phone with 1920x1080 with 5.5 inch screen. And the last of the segment is LG Q6 with a price tag of ₹12,999. It's again a full HD 5.5 inch screen, IPS display, 1080x2160. This is having a better resolution as compared to other, with a pixel density of about 2 pixel per inch with a Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection. See, what I've done is that there are 5 different phones. All 5 phones are having various flavors. I'll start with Honor 6X because it's the first phone in India which was launched with a dual camera. We have a K8 Note from Lenovo. This is one of the best selling phone on Amazon, and we are having some great reviews, and it's rated around 4.5 star in Amazon because of various reasons. I'll go into that. Moto G5S is again plain vanilla Android. There is always a support for this particular phone. You'll be getting Android Oreo 8 on this particular phone very soon. And the plus point over here is that it is a spill proof phone, or I can say it's not waterproof, but at least some spill of rain when you're moving in the rain, it is this phone has that much protection. Nokia 6, again, for those who are Nokia lovers, I think they will blindly go ahead and take this particular phone. It's having a 2.5D glass on it. I think Nokia 6 has come up with this particular feature. It's a good phone, but it's priced a little bit on the higher side. I don't think so why Nokia is pricing it at this particular range. The best price for Nokia 6 would be around 12,000 rupees, but 15,000 is too much for it. LG Q6, again, it's one of the new phone in this particular segment. $12,999 for an infinity display or a 18:9 display is a good price for this particular feature phone. The next part is the camera. I think we all like to have a good camera on our mobile, and especially the budget-friendly phones. So let's start with it. We'll start with Honor 6X, which is first in the line. So I said in the beginning itself, it is the first phone in India to come up with a dual camera setup. So it is having a 12 megapixel dual lens primary camera with autofocus, FF camera, and 8 megapixel front facing camera for selfie lover with PDF focusing. We'll move to the Lenovo K8 Note. It is having 13 plus 5 megapixel dual back camera and 13 megapixel front facing camera with wide angle selfie, party flash. You have a party flash in the front facing camera. It's having a professional mode, selfie beautification and timer mode. Coming to G5S, it's having a 16 megapixel primary camera. This is not a dual lens camera or dual camera setup at the back. It is having a single camera at the back with f2.0 PDF and 5 megapixel front facing camera with LED flash. This is good for the selfie lovers. Coming back to Nokia 6, it is having a 16 megapixel PDF primary camera and 8 megapixel autofocus front facing camera. This is the only phone which is having an AF with on the front facing camera. Moving on to the LG Q6, it is having a 30 megapixel primary camera with 5 megapixel front facing camera with wide angle selfie. So if you ask me the best of this entire segment, I will give it to Honor X6X and Lenovo K8 Note, only because they are having some good camera, good selfie cameras and higher end cameras placed at the front end for the selfie lovers. Moving on to the important aspect or important specification in a mobile phone is the OS in the processor. So for Honor 6X, the only down point over here is that it's still running on 6.0.1 Marshmallow operating system. Currently everyone is moving on to Nougat, but still it is running on 6.0.1 Marshmallow OS. It is having a 2.1 GHz plus 1.7 GHz octa core Kirin processor. It's a homegrown processor from Honor. Moving on to Lenovo K8 Note, it's on the latest v7.1.1 Nougat operating system. So be aware if there are any issues with your OS or any security concerns. So this phone has already been patched with the latest OS updated. It's having all Helio processor at 2.3 GHz into the X23 10 core processor. It's a hexa core processor. It's also a in-house build processor from Lenovo. Moving to Moto G5S, it's having again one of the latest OS installed on it, and it's already been promised that it will be moving on to the Oreo 8.0 in coming days or coming months. It's having a Snapdragon 430. It's a new processor from Snapdragon. It's an octa-core processor running at 1.4 GHz. Similarly, Nokia 6 is at running at Android 5 v7.1.1 Nougat OS. It is again upgradable to Oreo 8.0 in near future. These are all Moto G5S and Nokia 6. They are running on plain Android version of Google. It means it is having a vanilla Android. You can also call it as a not Android one, but plain vanilla Android. So expect Oreo 8.0 to be coming in the near future for Moto G5S and Nokia 6. Staying on the Nokia 6, it's having a Qualcomm Snapdragon 430 octa-core processor, which is the latest as of now. Then we move on to LG Q6. It's having 1.4 GHz Qualcomm Snapdragon processor running at 7.1.0 Nougat operating system. If you want your phone to be fast, super fast, then you are two things to be considered. One is the RAM, and if you are a selfie lover or you take more of photographs or you have installed more of your apps onto your mobile devices, then you think about the internal memory comparison. So this is where we are comparing now all these 5 phones with RAM and internal memory. So let's start with the Honor 6X, which is priced at 10,999. It is having a 4GB RAM, 64GB internal memory. So if your budget is very tight, I think you should go ahead and think about it. It can be extended up to 256GB. Use a second slot as a for a microSD, so there is no dedicated slot over here. Moving on to Lenovo K8, there is a dedicated slot, so this is one of the best points for Lenovo K8 Note. It is having 4GB RAM and 64GB internal memory, which is expandable up to 128GB. This is one of the best part of it. But I have tried using my 256GB memory card, and it works very well. So you can think about, if you are having a 256GB memory card, you can go ahead and insert it into your Lenovo K8 Note microSD card slot. Moving on to Moto G5S, this is also a 4GB RAM, but a slightly reduced internal memory, that is of 32GB internal memory, expandable up to 128GB. Moving on to Nokia 6, it's having 3GB RAM, slight less RAM. I think 3GB RAM is still sufficient for a vanilla Android, you know, device from Nokia 6. 32GB of internal memory if you are a photography lover or you install a lot of apps on it, and a game also, then it's going to be a little bit of, you know, space issue. But you can have a microSD card which is can be extended up to 56GB, but it uses again a SIM 2 slot. There is no dedicated slot for Nokia 6. Moving on to LG Q6, we have a dedicated slot. There is a 3GB RAM. Again, the price of 12,999, you are getting only 32GB of internal memory, which is on the lower side as of now. Coming into the trends on what, you know, the latest trend is now is that 32GB is the minimum, but going forward in 2018 it's going to be 64GB as the base variant for all the mobile devices, and it can be expandable up to 2TB. In today's world, if you are from India, we will like to have a dual SIM because of, you know, multiple operators giving multiple discounts, so we still prefer having two SIMs in our mobile. So yeah, let's see whether all these phones are dual SIM or not, whether they are having a dedicated slot or not. So all these five phones are having dual SIM, 4G plus 4G SIM with LTE support. The only downside over here is there are few of them which is having dedicated slot. I will go with Lenovo K8 Note because this is my preferred phone. But there is one more thing which we think more rather than, you know, having a dual SIM card, that is the battery. Whether my phone will be there, you know, if I'm charging it in the morning with 100% on and a heavy usage, will it be giving me a full day battery life? So let's go ahead and let's see how much, you know, milliamperes or how much power has been packed by these five phones. So when it comes to Honor 6, it's having a 3340 milliamperes battery. I think this is quite sufficient enough for a 5.5 inch full HD screen. As per them, they are saying that it will give you 23 hours of standby, and 23 hours of talk time, and 650 hours of standby with a fast charging of 5 volts 2 amperes fast charging technology. All these phones are fast charging, you know, they are having fast charging unit. When we move out to Lenovo K8 Note, which is my best, you know, preferred phone in all these five segments, it's having a dual SIM 4G plus 4G, a dedicated SIM slot, plus it is having 4000 mAh battery, which is again compared to all these five phones, it's the winner over here. With a turbo charging, it is having a 15 watt charger. So expect this phone to go up to in 30 minutes, you can be using it, this particular phone, for more than 5 to 6 hours. On G5S, you know, again it's a 4G plus 4G phone with a turbo charging available, but the battery is 3000 mAh, which is on the lower side as compared to, but 5.2 inch screen, I think it will give you a full day of 1 day to 1.5 days of your battery power. And moving on to Nokia 6, it's again having a 3000 mAh battery. I think 15,000 rupees and you're giving me a 3000 mAh battery, it's not a good deal for me. I'll move to the LG Q6. Again, it is having a good display density, pixel PPI of 400 plus. So I think 3000 milliampere battery is not going to be sufficient enough to run this particular phone for a full day. So everyone will thinking, you know, what all sensors are available in this particular phone. You know, whether they, when I'm saying that it's a budget friendly phone, how much sensor they are packing in, whether it's having a fingerprint sensor or not. So let's go ahead and check this out. So all this phone except LG Q6 is having a fingerprint sensor. LG Q6 don't have a fingerprint sensor because they went with an 18:9 aspect ratio, and there's a place where they were not able to put a fingerprint sensor in the front, or not they had a fingerprint place for a fingerprint sensor at the back. So as I said, except LG Q6, all the four phones, that is Honor 6X, Lenovo K8 Note, Moto G5S and Nokia 6, all these four phones are having a fingerprint sensor in the front, except the Lenovo K8 Note and the Honor 6X. So all of these phones are having a gyroscope. The only down point over here is Moto G5S is not having a FM radio. So if you are a if you love music and if you are daily listening to your FM radio, when you're traveling every now and then, moving to your office or moving somewhere else, and you want FM radio to be in place, I think Moto G5S is not the phone for you. It's not having FM radio on it. So as I said, I will be going ahead with Lenovo K8 Note only. So the reason why is because it's a budget friendly phone. It's having all the features which I want. It's having a dual camera with a fast selfie camera of, you know, having more pixels on it. It's having all these sensors on it. It's having a proximity sensor, light sensor, e-compass, gyro sensor. So I'll go ahead with K8 Note. Before I end this particular vlog, you know, there is some giveaway also happening. There is an Mi A1 which is going to be a giveaway happening in this coming weeks. So do go ahead and subscribe to this particular channel. Hit the like button and go ahead and comment in the below section. You can go ahead and share this particular video. The only way to win Mi A1 is, you know, a subscription, a like and a comment in it. So if you have all these three done, I think you are having more chances to go ahead and win this particular Mi A1 device. Also, do let me know if you want to have any questions on this particular devices, you want to do some reviews or you want to have some question on any other devices, please put in the comment section. So this is Shiv over here signing for today. Have a great day and a wonderful evening. Please take care of yourself. Bye. Take care. Thank you so much.